Hey, BC here for BC Nephro. Thanks for watching. I'm Dr. Brian Cronin, board certified nephrologist and clinical specialist in hypertension. Today's topic, causes of a low anion gap. But before we get into that, make sure you check out the other videos at this channel. Check out bcnephro.com where you'll find articles not only on this topic, but on a wide range of nephrology subjects. I'm also on Instagram at bcnephro. Links to all will be in the description below. But now let's get into it. The anion gap is calculated by the formula sodium minus the sum of chloride plus bicarbonate, sodium the major positively charged ion, cation, and chloride and bicarbonate being the major negatively charged ions, anions in the body. Now, in reality, all the positive and negative charges in the body are equal. So what the anion gap really is the sum of the unmeasured anions minus the unmeasured cations, there typically being more unmeasured anions than cations. Now, the anion gap is typically used in the evaluation of metabolic acidosis. In metabolic acidosis, typically the serum bicarbonate is decreased, consumed by the acid load, and another anion is increased to maintain electrolyte neutrality. This can either be chloride in hyperchloremic metabolic acidosis where the anion gap will remain normal, but if there is another anion, such as lactate in lactic acidosis or beta-hydroxybutyrate in ketoacidosis, this is not measured and used in the formula, so there will be an anion gap. I will link an article and video in the description below on an overview of the evaluation of metabolic acidosis. But there are also certain situations where the anion gap can be decreased or even negative. Typically, an anion gap of less than 3 is considered low. We're going to go over 3 physiologic principles, 3 general physiologic reasons why the anion gap can be low or even negative. Before we get into that, if you're liking this video, make sure to like it and subscribe to the channel. If you know someone who may be interested in learning about this topic, please share this video. It's spreading the message word of mouth and doing these things that helps the channel grow and get this education to more people. Now, causes of below anion gap. The most common cause is going to be simply lab error. So in most cases, if you find a low anion gap, you should simply repeat the lab. Now, in cases where the anion gap is persistently low, there are a couple physiologic reasons or principles. The first is that there is some condition that causes an artificial reading. So if there is a condition that causes the measured serum sodium to be artificially low, below what the true serum sodium is, or the measured serum chloride to be artificially high, higher than the true chloride value, this will result in a low or even negative anion gap. There are a couple causes of an artificially low serum sodium. The first is severe hypernatremia. Now, the sodium assays are not calibrated to be as accurate when there is very severe hypernatremia. I'm talking about serum sodium values of 170 or higher. So the reading you get in this situation may be lower than the true reading. The second is something called pseudohyponatremia. This is when the serum sodium is artificially low and typically occurs in conditions where there is an increased solid phase of plasma. Most commonly, I've seen this in severe hypertriglyceridemia. I'm talking about triglyceride levels in the several thousand or higher range. I will link an article and video on an overview of hyponatremia in the description below that goes into this phenomenon in more detail. Now, in addition to issues with the sodium, there can be something called pseudo-hyperchloremia. The chloride reading is artificially elevated. This occurs when there is a presence of another anion in the body that cross-reacts with the chloride assay, which is most commonly something called bromide. There can be bromide intoxication, also referred to as bromism, with chronic intake of bromide. Bromide is something that is in certain medications. It had in the past been in certain over-the-counter medications, but was removed because of this condition, but it remains in several medications, including dextromorphan, certain medications used for the treatment of myasthenia gravis, and certain herbal preparations. This condition can be associated with significant clinical manifestations, which can be neurologic, psychiatric, gastrointestinal, or skin manifestations, and a low or negative anion gap caused by an artificially high chloride can be a clinical clue that leads to this diagnosis. Now, the second reason for an artificially low anion gap is a decrease in the unmeasured anions. Now, the major unmeasured anion is albumin. So this occurs most commonly in hypoalbuminemia, and hypoalbuminemia is the second most common cause of a low anion gap. Because of this, there is a correction formula to calculate a corrected anion gap for the low albumin. Essentially, for every decrease in albumin by one, the anion gap decreases by 2.5. So in the calculation, you add 2.5 to the anion gap for every decrease in one below 4.5, the serum albumin. I'll put this formula in the description below as well. Now, the third cause of a low anion gap is an increase in unmeasured cations. Now, when I say unmeasured, I mean not in the formula of sodium minus the sum of chloride plus bicarbonate. So this means a cation other than sodium. Many of these are actually measured in the chemistries and include calcium, potassium, and magnesium. So elevation of any of these levels can cause a low anion gap. There are certain other cations that are not routinely measured that can cause this as well. One is lithium. So in a patient with lithium toxicity, a clue to this can be a low anion gap. And certainly in a patient who is on lithium chronically or has taken a medication overdose, the finding of a low anion gap should spur the measurement of a lithium level. The other is the presence of abnormal proteins, typically monoclonal or polyclonal immunoglobulin IgG. These are positively charged and can cause a low anion gap. So the finding of an unexplained low anion gap should lead to the measurement of paraproteins. So that's it. Thanks for watching. If you made it this far, you might as well hit like and subscribe. Leave a comment. Have you ever experienced a low anion gap? And until next time.